and thank you again to the Adia Gies Foundation. I display the beautiful bust of Dr. Gies in my office with great pride. It sits underneath three iconic pictures of New York City, and when anyone leaves my office, they have to see that bust and often comment, and then I get to give a wonderful narration. Along with my friend and colleague, D. Walter Cohen, here tonight with me, we were honored to nominate the Hedwig van Ameringen Executive Leadership in Academic Medicine Program, better known as the ELAM program, for a Gies Award. In 1993, a needs assessment examined the lack of diversity in academic healthcare leadership. At that time, there were only three women deans of medical schools and no deans, women deans of dental schools. Just 2 years later, Walter, along with remarkable colleagues, founded the ELAM program, now at Drexel University. ELAM offers an intensive one-year fellowship of leadership training with solid coaching, networking, and mentoring opportunities. The first class of ELAM fellows numbered just 25. The second class of ELAM fellows wasn't much larger, and that was the class I was in with Pam Zarkowski. We were the first two dental medicine ELAM fellows. The number of ELAM fellows has increased exponentially, and there are now more than 900 alums, and I am so proud to call myself one of these alums. Let's learn more about ELAM.
I became the first woman president of the American Board of Oral and Maxillofacial Pathology in its 60-plus year history. And then subsequently, I became the first woman president of the American Academy of Oral and Maxillofacial Pathology in its 60-plus year history. So those were achievements I had hoped to try for and gain, and my wish came true, and I think ELAM helped me realize those.
The Executive Leadership in Academic Medicine program, known as ELAM, emerged from a needs assessment conducted in 1993 that examined the diversity of academic healthcare leadership. In 1995, ELAM was established to address the challenges of advancing women leaders in academic health centers. The program's vision is part of the International Center for Executive Leadership in Academics at Drexel University College of Medicine.
For me, the ELAM experience, I think, was literally, truly a life-changing experience personally. And it gave me the start, the opportunity that I needed to take my first job as dean in a dental school.
ELAM offers an intensive one-year fellowship of leadership training. Its first class of ELAM fellows numbered 25. Today, the annual class size is 54 fellows, and ELAM alumni number nearly 900.
What ELAM does, it equips you that when you move in those positions, you can be impactful. You can be a force there.
The program has received broad national recognition, including the Dr. Edward B. Shills Entrepreneurial Education Fund Award, the Women in Medicine Leadership Development Award, plus grants from the Robert Wood Johnson Foundation and the National Institutes of Health.
ELAM allowed me to explore something I hadn't considered, was to move up to the associate dean position. And because of that, I had the confidence and the background and the tools by which to seek that type of position and move into, which where I am now blessed to be.
Celebrating 20 years as the only in-depth national program dedicated to preparing senior women faculty at schools of medicine, dentistry, and public health to effect sustained, positive, transformative change as institutional leaders is the Executive Leadership in Academic Medicine program.
It is so gratifying for Patty Cormier and myself to see the tremendous success of the ELAM program, which we had the privilege of founding at the Medical College of Pennsylvania more than 20 years ago. Integrating medical and dental female academicians in this effort is now expanded to other disciplines, such as engineering and public health. Credit for its wonderful outcomes is in large part due to the excellence of the faculty and the more than 900 unusual women who are ELAMs. We're extremely grateful to Paige Moorhand, Rosalind Richmond, and Diane McGrain for their leadership, which has resulted in this Gies Award. Such a wonderful gift to our community. Before I present this award, may I ask that if you're affiliated with the ELAM program, please stand. Thank you. In 2015, ELAM celebrates its 20th anniversary and is also celebrating the 2015 Gies Award for Outstanding Vision by Public or Private Partner. Here to accept the award are Dr. Diane McGrain, Executive Director, International Leadership in Academics at Drexel University, and the initial directors of the program, Dr. Paige Moorhand and Rosalind Richmond.
For those of you who don't know us, I'm Diane McGrain. Paige Moorhand is holding Dr. Gies's bust. and Rosalind Richmond on her left. Thank you, Walter. Thank you, Lisa. Thank you, Selection Committee, for this amazing timing for us and for me personally to be on the podium. You know, I wish Connie were in the audience and not on the screen, because she would have really found this delicious. To be here on an evening when you're honoring two people that have mentored me personally over the course of my life, Jean Sinkford, whom I know has mentored many of you as well, and Carol Eschenbrenner, who has been looking after me for 30 years. It's a very special moment that honors a vision that started when Patty Cormier said to Walter, "Walter, there are not enough women in leadership, and we need to do something about this." And he agreed and proceeded and tapped Paige, and Paige tapped Roz. And as you heard, this it started out from medicine with Jean. I understand Jean Sinkford had something to do with the dental, with Lisa and Pam coming in that second class. So, you know, what a force that has contributed to this evolution. 20 years later, two-thirds of dental schools have had a fellow participate in this program. And as you heard, there are not enough women dental school deans, but most of them have graduated from the ELAM program. The very best way to talk about its impact is to show it. And so I would ask again, if those of you who are, so Walter coined this phrase, an ELAM alumna is an ELAM, and we've extended that to the graduates of the ELATE program. If you're an ELAM, will you please stand and remain standing, please? Now, we all deserve that. If you're a dean who has sponsored an ELAM fellow over the last 20 years, will you please join them in standing? If you're a dean or a CEO who has recruited a fellow from another school to yours, you can join these. Seriously, it happens that way too. If you've worked on a committee or with a group with any of these magnificent women, will you please stand? I know there are lots of you, please. And if you have been mentored by any of these ELAM fellows, will you join them? Walter, Paige, Roz, look what you have done. Thank you so much.